and McCain. He also is going after you now. Today, the 60th anniversary of Israel's independence. He says you're not necessarily endorsing policies that would be good for Israel. He says this, for example. I think it's very clear who Hamas wants to be the next president of the United States. I think that people should understand that I will be Hamas's worst nightmare. If Senator Obama is favored by Hamas, I think people can make judgments accordingly.
Yeah, this is offensive. And I think it's disappointing because John McCain always says, well, I'm not going to run that kind of politics. And then to engage in that kind of smear, I think, is unfortunate, particularly since my policy towards Hamas has been no different than his. I've said that they are a terrorist organization, that we should not negotiate with them unless they recognize Israel or renounce violence, and unless they are willing to abide by previous accords between the Palestinians and the Israelis. And so for him to toss out comments like that, I think is an example of him losing his bearings as he pursues this nomination. We don't need name-calling in this debate. What we're going to need is to have a serious conversation about how do we keep nuclear weapons out of the hands of the Iranian regime. How do we broker a peace deal between the Israelis and the Palestinians that allows both sides to benefit? Israel assuring its security and its status as a Jewish state, the Palestinians able to have a contiguous functioning state where their people can prosper. And if we end up continuing to be locked up in these ideological arguments, playing politics of the sort that we've seen John McCain doing recently, then I think, frankly, we're going to miss an opportunity to really move this country in a better direction and to reset our foreign policy in a way that I think the world is anxious for. The world wants to see the United States lead. They've been disappointed and disillusioned over the last 7, 8 years, but I think there is still a sense everywhere I go that, you know, if the United States regains its sense of who it is and our values and our ideals, that we will continue to set the tone for creating a more peaceful and prosperous world. I want to move